Hello everyone and welcome back to White One Racing. Today we'll talk about the shafts, the crankshafts, and the advantages and disadvantages related to the intake phase and the shape of the shoulder. Let's start with a small inventory of the material available today. Original Vespa 200 shaft. Now, almost all of them are from the 200 here. There is only one from the 125, but we are only interested in showing the shape of the shoulder. We don't care, we're not going to talk about the connecting rung length now, or whether it's 125 or 200, it's just about the intake phase. This is still an original Piaggio shaft, but in this case of the 125 and 150, however, it has been processed, delayed and then rebalanced at 12 o'clock by removing part of the counterweight on the flywheel side, on the opposite side. Then we have the Mazzucchelli shaft, this one from 200, Mazzucchelli advanced, highly advanced and unbalanced, stroke 60 shaft. In this case, connecting rod 116 on a Tameni base, which had a round flywheel and was elaborated and balanced. 200 Pinasco shaft. Sorry. Jasil shaft. Stroke 57. This too is delayed. It comes like this as standard. Pinasco shaft in stroke 60. Pinasco racing shaft, in this case in stroke 57. It changes among other things because it has the original closed balancing hole, the balancing tungsten pads. Even if it's not balanced, in any case, it's not balanced at 12 o'clock. Then, just for showing, a special type of elaborated shaft for reed. The roundup hands here, and then there is still, it was left in the box because it's the most valuable one. It's a BGM shaft, stroke 60 delayed. As you can see, the shoulder is identical to that of the Jasil. Here it is. Introductions are done. A necessary clarification. First, I called some shaft advanced. None of these crankshafts are actually advanced. The fact is that the brands themselves call them advanced very often. In reality, these of the Vespa Larger are all delayed. Those worked on the aspiration can only be delayed. They couldn't be anticipated because on the advanced side there is the crank button, so you cannot advance. Advanced are instead those of the Vespa Small. Those, yes, they are all worked on the advance, so they are called advanced. In reality, there is a shaft, but it is a case in itself, which is also clearly anticipated. It is the Quattrini. But it is a very special case. The one has its own thermal unit. It must be mounted like this. It has another completely different shaft that requires special crankcase boring. So another story. These shafts here, yes, there are some, but it's a small thing really. It's just about the delay. One thing that I have not said before is that the Pinasco shafts that I presented, this which would be the racing one, which is the tungsten, and the Pinasco non-racing shaft. These two are also distinguished by length, by the width of the delay, because the racing is clearly more delayed than a good 10 degrees. Now you can also see less here because what is not racing has also been slightly touched on the delay, but there is a notable difference. Let's get to the point now. Questions often arise about the best shape of the shaft shoulder, the ideal delay, the ideal crankcase volume. It's all relative. In reality, there is no better shape. There are shapes that are best suited to the various operating conditions of the engine, to the characteristics of the thermal unit, to the wishes of the tuner too, who wants to achieve one result or the other. So let's start with an original shaft. This is an original 200 shaft, but that's just to show you the starting point. This is the basis of the elaboration, so this is standard. You see what the shoulder looks like, but most of you I think already know. It has a very modest delay. The intake phase on the 200, which has the long valve, is no longer overhaul than 160 degrees, with a delay of around 55 or something like that. Now, this modest delay lends itself to an extremely resilient engine, and not as powerful as that of the original 200 for the type of thermal unit it has. However, it is an excellent basis for tuning. By doing small work on the delay, it is possible to obtain notable increases in performance. By the way, we've shown this in a specific video. Now, getting to the heart of this matter, we need to talk about the shape of the shoulder. That of the original 200 is like this. Then, this is a first step, even if it is specifically a shaft of the 125 of tuning, which also lends itself to 177 in this case. We can speak of an upgraded original 200. Or even better, performing cylinders that you want to make work in a very soft and elastic way without focusing on maximum performance. Let us now examine this shaft. This is the Mazzucchelli as shown earlier, Mazzucchelli delayed. It has a very significant delay. In fact, I tell you one thing, if you have one available, the limit represents the delay limit not to be exceeded for any reason, especially if, with this shoulder shape. And let's talking about the shape of the shoulder. At the antipodes, there is, with equal delay, let's say, the shape of the Mazzucchelli shoulder cut this way, and the shape of the Pinasco racing shoulder, which is hollowed out on to the maximum, thinned inside, so as not to present obstacles to the flow at the inlet of the valve. Some balancing is clearly mandatory, thus removing a lot of material from the other shoulder. Mazzucchelli is naturally unbalanced. In short, it comes out like this. If you have to you have to balance it and cut a piece. Now, there are supporters and detractors about the utility, the theory about the utility of digging a lot in the shoulder, like Pinasco. What can I tell you? I don't want to side with either part. I just think that this process can be useful or harmful, depending on the purpose you want to achieve. Keep in mind that if you work the shoulder a lot, the shaft will need to be balanced a lot. So it will lose mass, which in itself is a performance disadvantage. However, it's true that this shape facilitates the entry of gas into the crankcase. Higher rev performance will be privileged and torque will be mortified. This is the result. There is, however, and I took it on purpose among others, the BGM shoulder, which represents a very valid compromise between the two extremes. So let's take back the BGM together with the poor brother, who is the Jasil. This is BGM, which differs from Jasil mainly by the connecting rod, which is better. This one is the last BGM. Those before had a connecting rod a little more similar to that of the Jasil, but the shoulder is essentially identical. I was saying, I consider this type of inspiration shoulder process to be really valid, because it represents a good compromise between minimizing obstacles to the incoming flow and maintaining a reasonable weight of the shaft even after balancing at 12 o'clock, which is very important. Among other things, these shafts have a not exaggerated intake phase. The shoulders have about one centimeter more than the limit represented by the Mazzucchelli cut, which however can be advantageous advantageously removed if you want to squeeze the engine more, also benefiting from the sweet shape of the shoulder profile. Among other things, another consideration, this is very important, the advantage of having a more voluminous crankcase and therefore a more worked shoulder is that it allows, without regurgitation, it allows you to exploit the advantages of a long suction phase, long intake phase, before, therefore with a significant delay. If the crankcase is too full and the phase is too delayed, the crankcase volume is smaller, and therefore it will be easier to have low revs regurgitation. This is another element that must be kept in mind. It goes in the right direction though, because the more you want to push the engine and the more you want to move the efficiency up, the more you can afford to empty the crankcase and delay. Otherwise, if you do not want, if you don't want to achieve this, but the opposite effect, that is favoring the elasticity of operation at low revs, it's better to keep the crankcase rather full and reduce the delay. Weight is another issue. All things being equal, the heavier shaft makes the engine run better. This is well established. An important consideration regarding the possibility of using a conspicuous delay with advantage. That is very much conditioned by the length of the manifold. So if the Mazzucchelli delay represents a limit for engines powered with an SI carburetor, this limit can be widely exceeded, and by that I mean some 10 degrees. If you are using, for example, even a 30mm carburetor with its long manifold, because the long manifold causes an A column to be present, whose inertia inhibits regurgitation. This is especially true for engines such as the Quattrini 244, which has its own dedicated shaft with a very long connecting rod. So there is also the advantage of a large volume in the crankcase, and you get delay, and you get delays, really conspicuous delays. There are those who have delayed it up to 85 degrees without having problems, which would be an absolutely unattainable limit just to be able to start a Vespa with an SI carburetor. If you like this video, leave a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Remember, White Run Racing is not a workshop, but an amateur sport association that works on engines only for sport purposes and only for its associates.